Good day to you all. Welcome back once again to my channel. My name is Chekwema Dichie. Today I want us to learn the process of generating a volatility series using the standard Gauge model framework, and we are going to be using Bitcoin prices expressed in US dollars. Daily Bitcoin prices from 16th of August 2010 to 1st of April 2021, giving us 3,882 observations. So we want to generate the volatility series for these Bitcoin prices, okay? And the starting point is for us to visualize using a graph or plot to look at the trend in daily Bitcoin prices, and of course go into determining the Arch effect. The Arch effect will show us whether the Arch family model is actually appropriate for generating this volatility series. So here is the data. The data is generated from the Quandro database. Quandro database. And here we have the data from day one to the last day. Okay. So, what do we do? We can make a quick plot to see how it is. Of course, you can see how it is, and you can see that it has the nature of non-stationarity. Non-stationarity, which means that we may be going to use a log difference to make it to appear in terms of return. So return, right? Assets return. So now it is more like an asset return as we have it here. But for us to actually work with this, we can generate this because if we keep it this way, it might eventually disappear and give us something else. Okay. Now we can go to quick, but if you want to generate the return variable, you can use generate and call it BTC. First of all, you have to return it to its original state by going back to default and closing. Okay, now here you can generate the return series by calling it BTCR equals log of You can do it this way: current BTC minus past year yesterday BTC divided by yesterday BTC. So there are many ways you can do that. You can say this minus BTC minus 1, okay, divided by BTC minus 1. Okay, so you can use brackets to cover it so that we don't make mistake. Okay, so how it is now, you can click OK. Now this has entered, and this is exactly what we had when we converted this to log difference. This is exactly what we had. And you can also use another method to generate this series. It will still give you the same thing. For instance, you may want to use log method, and that log method you can make it to look like something else. Can say BTC RR equals log in brackets BTC current minus BTC yesterday. Okay, so this actually can also no divided, I think. So we are talking about division here. Okay, so this also is the same thing with what we have generated so far. So now the volatility we are going to generate, the volatility series, we can consider the two major series we have here for BTC. You can now see the evidence of volatility here. You know, it goes up, it comes down below the zero line, and goes up and comes down below the, that is what shows us evidence of volatility. Okay, now you may consider this also, but this also has a nature of non-stationarity. Assuming we want to test for unit root, okay, this unit root, so it has nature of non-stationarity, which means that it is integrated. You can see that it is other one originally, but when you use BTC as return, you can see that it is stationary the way it is here. You can see that it is stationary. So what are we going to do? We return to spreadsheet. The next thing to do here is to test for arch effect, okay, because we are going to be using the GASH model, and testing for arch effect is to give us a go ahead order that the pattern of volatility here follows can be modeled with arch family models. Okay, so what do? We go to quick estimate equation. So we consider the BTCR. Okay, see, minus one. So we run the current BTC on its past yesterday value and test for arch effect using arch. Okay, so you can see the option I'm choosing. There you can see that the null hypothesis of homoscedasticity is rejected. Okay, so there is a strong evidence of arch effects. So with this, it also shows us that we can now go ahead to estimate the GASH model. We now move to arch here. You can see what I chose. Go to arch. Here you leave it at GASH, arch 1, GASH 1. So GASH 1 means having two components, the component of arch and the component of GASH. Come here and select EView legacy. Every other thing remaining the way it is. You can use normal Gaussian for error distribution, and you click OK. So the result is out. We can briefly talk on this result. First of all, we see that the past BTC return has strong effect on current BTC return, and coming here, this segment of this model is very, very important. This shows us that this measures the speed, I mean the extent to which the current volatility goes into future volatility. So this gauge here, the sum of the two, when it is equals to one, it shows that volatility is persistent. And of course, when you add these two, you have something that can be approximated to one, or approximated to one, showing that volatility is persistent here. Okay, now how do we generate the volatility series of this analysis? You go to probe, you go to make GASH variance series. Okay, remember the video is on generating the volatility series using GASH model framework, and the experimental variable here is daily Bitcoin prices. Okay, so we click on this. Now we can rename this to give us the name we want the Bitcoin return volatility variable. So we can call it BTC return volatility. Okay, so this is the volatility series. We click OK. So you can now see the volatility series. Okay, the volatility series. So this volatility series will now be used for further analysis, assuming one wants to either look at what determines the volatility of Bitcoin prices by looking at other variables that may contribute to this. You can also look at how this volatility of Bitcoin affect other variables, because we already have the series here. Thank you very much for your time. Please don't forget to subscribe. For new viewers, please kindly subscribe and turn on the notification bell, so that anytime video drops, you get to see it first. Thank you very much, and remember.